State of the Union with Candy Coley, CNN Sunday morning, 9 Eastern.
Joining us now from Little Rock, Arkansas, is CNN contributor General Wesley Clark, former NATO Supreme Allied Commander. Let me make some use of that, General Clark, to just ask you, NATO is set to decide whether they're going to join this coalition to take military action. Is there any doubt in your mind that NATO won't join?
You know, it really depends on the internal politics of the countries there and how this is perceived. Every country has its own internal political dynamic. There are traditionally a lot of interest in Libya and Libyans living in Italy, so Italy has had some concerns. Germany doesn't want to be engaged in another ground operation. They've already had troops in Afghanistan, and so these countries are going to have to be persuaded to go along. But I think they will be ultimately. But Candy, it's more important that we get Arab participation than that we have the visible symbol of NATO. It's not as effective to have NATO involved diplomatically as an organization as it would be to have very strong forward leadership from the Arab League and the Organization of Islamic Conference and even the African Union. The more regional pressure that can be put on Gaddafi, the more legitimacy the operation will gain.
And yet we have heard certainly from the British, and I did ask Admiral Mullen about this earlier, but the British are saying, well, we think that the UAE, United Arab Emirates, and we think that Qatar will be helpful to us. We don't know if they will be militarily involved. Is it not important in some ways to have some military involvement by countries in the region?
Yes, it would be important, and obviously it's what would be sought, and as the no-fly zone is implemented, I think it's more likely that we'll get more overt participation from those countries because the risks will go down, the risk of embarrassment. But, you know, just to pick back up on something that Nick said, if this goes down into a stalemate, which it could, then all the pressure is on the diplomacy. And in that case, it may be more useful to us that some of these countries that are aligned with us don't participate militarily but use their diplomatic leverage to try to pry Gaddafi out of power in Libya.
One of the things that's been interesting as we follow this over the course of the past couple of days is the real need publicly for the U.S. to kind of say, well, we're just kind of in the back row here, and we're just part of this thing. And we heard Admiral Mullen say, well, over the next couple of days, we want to hand over command and control to somebody else. And yet, the U.S. certainly played a heavy part in the Tomahawk missiles that came in from the sea. Most of them were ours. We had 19 planes that were degrading some of Gaddafi's air defense weaponry. We are currently in command and control. So is this a question where we're saying we're really not, you know, a big part of this, we're just a part of the group, but we actually still are? I get politically why we have to not be leading this. But isn't it the truth that in the end, the U.S. is the only one that can lead it?
Not necessarily. We have the can opener. What we did with the Tomahawk missiles and the takedown of the air defense system there is a standard. It's a playbook play that our military forces have run time and again. I saw it, and it worked extremely well when we were operating in Kosovo 11 years ago and 12 years ago. So we know how to do this. Nobody else has the technology to do that. But that having been done, the real work comes in the art of balancing the no-fly zone, the strikes on ground forces with the diplomacy. There's no reason the United States has to lead that. In fact, it's better if we don't. It gives more space for maneuver, and it keeps our national leadership from making this a head-on conflict with Gaddafi. Because if it goes in that direction, then the outcome is that we're going to be drawn into a ground war in Libya. And certainly the United States doesn't want that. That's been one of the reservations we've had. And when we started this, we'd be on the slippery slope down. Now, I think the European leadership, and we can get some Arab leadership in there at the same time, to be the face of this operation and actually lead it diplomatically, make use of the military leverage that's provided with the no-fly zone, but then work to get Gaddafi out. That's the heart of the operation. We'll be behind it, as the president said, but we don't have to lead it.
Militarily, General, when you look at this situation now, what would you be most worried about?
Militarily, I'd be worried about he's going to try to find a way around our ability to use air power to block the ground forces. So we heard this morning that aircraft, don't know whose they were yet, struck that column of armored vehicles that was heading toward Benghazi, apparently just devastated it. That's great. The day of the orange-painted tank in the desert is over. We knew that. I guess the Libyans had to learn the hard way. But there are other ways to get forces moved around and positioned. And if he does that and the fighting begins and it's a sort of house-to-house combat in cities, that makes it a difficult matter to resolve from the air.